Today we are talking about 2023 goals, our goals, your goals, how to reach them, and basically just how to have the best year yet, and a ton of other side piece information that you guys need to know.
Let's go, new year, new me, baby. Also, but your same couple tea. It's episode 17. That 17. Felt like a really fire plug. Was that not fire?
That was good. That was
that
good.
That felt like a good transition. I like that. Also, it's been a while.
It's crazy because, okay, first of all, we're sorry. We're back. We're back. That's the good news. We did take a little break, not because of any other reason besides the fact
busy.
We were in Michigan, visiting family, the holidays.
Everything's
so,
coming up. You know. But we do have some hot, spicy tea for you guys.
Ooh.
Also, a little motivation. Sprinkle in some cinnamon
some
on top. Some cinnamon on top for some
spice.
Goals, some spice, some tea. We got it all today.
Okay, so since 2023 is coming up, I just have a question. You know, the whole like big like, oh, New Year's
resolutions. Say that out loud one more time.
2023 is here, baby.
Like, are you serious?
2023 is going to be the year.
Yo, 2023 is stacking up to be one of the biggest years for the JD fam. Mm-hmm. We're super excited. We have a lot of goals, a lot of big things coming up.
A lot of projects.
A lot of projects.
Stuff, like, not secret projects anymore, which is exciting stuff.
Not everything's a secret anymore, but we are so excited and we want to be on here and talk to you guys. And we want to know about your 2023 goals and also kind of reflect a little bit on 2022. Cause I think it's
such
good.
A good year.
This is something we do like daily, or I know I write it down like my goals. And then like, I'm trying to reflect now at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's good to do at the end of the year. I just actually watched a fan edit, which was so fire. It literally recapped our 2022 and like it almost brought tears to my eyes.
Well, it's crazy because you almost forget all the stuff that happened and like the hard stuff, the good stuff. And then when you think about it all in one, you're like, you know what? This actually, like, there was so much in that year. Cause sometimes I feel like time feels like it can go by so fast.
Well,
but then you like
back,
watch back, you're like, holy crap, we did a lot this
looking
year. We
back
went
at like January last year, I it feels like years ago.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
But then again, when you really think about it and like, you know, it's already been a whole year. Like, it's almost 2023. Like, what's going on? Like, time's flying.
I really think that reflecting on your year is really good, even if it was a hard year. I think reflecting on anything that you went through or something good, something bad, it's like if it's something good, then you're going to be like reminded like how grateful you are. And then if it's like bad, you like can remind yourself that you got through that. Like, I went through that.
Preach.
And now it's a new year. And now it's like just clear, like fresh beginning. And like, that is the best feeling in the world. And that's why I feel like everyone loves like the whole new year, new me. And I have a question.
Let me stop you right there. That's the whole reason why we started the podcast. Cause one day KDB was giving advice,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, yo, people need to hear this. Like, it comes so natural to you. Like,
thanks.
You're going to be an inspiration to people out there. It's like,
stop.
Let's do a podcast. You can be in people's ears while they're working, driving, whatever it is. And just preach, you know, and I'm just gonna sit here and narrate everything.
No, give the best advice, I swear. Like, sometimes I'm like, oh, I can't stay. Like, I'll be like mad about something, and Josh is like, oh, well, that person didn't mean it like that, like this. I'm like, can you stop being like a good person for like 5 minutes? Because like, I love it
days.
Though, because like we like put each other in check. I feel like a lot of times it's really helpful.
No, 100%. And in today's episode, we want to give you guys tips and also just like a little backstory and stuff and everything for our 2023.
Mm-hmm.
But that was the first tip, was reflecting, which is super important, like you were saying. So what's one thing you want to reflect on from 2022?
Something I want to like look back at.
I don't know, just anything. Like when you think reflecting, like where's your head go? Because I know I'll start.
One thing that I can 100% reflect on was that your mom being with us at Christmas was a gift from God. The fact that your mom did not pass from COVID was like, that's no coincidence to me. And that to me, like, I feel like grows stronger in my faith too, because I'm like, they literally told us that she was dead and now it's like she's totally fine. Like, she has some issues, but like nothing like,
it's
I mean,
insane.
Just a little pain, you know, nothing like crazy. So it's like, that was such a miracle.
Super quick backstory. If you're not like a follower, haven't been following JD Vlogs, because we haven't talked about this really on the podcast that
mm-hmm.
much, is my mom had COVID. She was in a coma for 2 months.
Two plus, I think.
They basically said like to pull the plug. She was going to be a vegetable, like all this crazy stuff. And then like a miracle happened and my mom came out of it. And
which,
here,
like,
we are today. We got to celebrate Christmas with my mom, and then she's going to go into 2023. We're filming this on, what is this, 29?
Yeah, 29th.
29, so a couple more days. Tomorrow's New Year's Eve.
And what's crazy is, like, we went through this all in the beginning of this year, and we were like, this is, like, such a bad start to this year.
That's what I thought. I forgot about that. I'm like, yo, with how bad of a start we had to the year, like, look how amazing it turned out.
But, like, things
still... It just
still
proves that, like, if you can just power through things, like, obviously... that was just emotional. And yeah. Like, you know, thank God, like our prayers
another miracle that I think is going on right now is my little cousin Reagan. I know you guys know a little bit about that, but her chemo is actually working. So that is huge news.
We got a miracle in the beginning of the year.
Her cancer
at the end of the year
is 40% reduced, which is insane. So she's absolutely crushing it. Shout out Reagan. You're such too. A little fighter. Jeez. And like, that is just like the best news in the world. So it's like, there is so much good, even in the bad, that I think it's always good to pay attention to, because you could like ask yourself like, oh, why does this happen to my family? Like, why does this happen yep. to my mom? But yep. like, even like your mom, like, it's like, okay, look how much stronger she is now because of it. And like, look at like everyone else's perspective on like what happened. It's like, I don't know. It's just crazy.
Yeah, it's insane to even think about that. But let's reflect on something. Well, that is very positive.
You mean more like...
But it started bad.
That started
and,
good.
You know, it was very emotional. It was hard to get through. But with all that going on, you know, we still got things done. And we were able to launch the Move app successfully this
year.
That was like kind of a passion project for myself 100% and mm-hmm. you also. Like, that is what... If you go back to our first ever vlogs together... We go to the gym every day.
Oh, it's always.
Like, what did we used to say in the videos? Gains. Am I blanking on what it was?
Gains, baby. I don't know.
Like something about gains. Like we just always would say gains. It was just a joke. Like it was always fun content. Like,
gains, baby.
But like we went to the gym in every single video, and that is even when we're like realized how passionate we were about working out.
Yeah.
And I actually screenshotted. On the JD Fit Instagram, if you go back to when we just made it like a fitness workout page.
Oh my gosh.
There's a picture where I'm sitting on like a workout equipment thing and I'm holding my phone. And the caption is, would you guys buy a workout program from us? In 2018.
Oh, really?
4 years later, we drop a fitness app. Isn't
that
insane?
That's probably way crazier than we ever even imagined.
I never thought I would own an app in my life. Like, that sounds insane. Like, when I click on Instagram, I'm like, wow, like, this app is insane. And then I'm like, we literally have, like, an app like that.
It's crazy.
Like, we have an app.
Okay, so since we're talking about, like, fitness and stuff like that, my question for you is like, what would you tell someone who their goal is to get fit? Like, okay, I know that's like the
okay,
most common goal.
Let me just stop you there. First things first is you can sign up on the Move app right now for $1, and that's ending soon. And we're also doing a 90-day fitness challenge where we're going to be working out with you guys, and we're going to be picking someone to win a couple of people $1,000 in prizes.
So that alone should be motivation.
That's motivation right there. And it only costs $1 for your first month. Like, no, there is like, not a cheaper... costing workout app on the app store right now, unless we're talking free, but there are free apps out there. But you know, the amount of work and quality we put into this app, like,
yeah, sometimes I feel like the free apps don't really,
yeah. I mean, we've all used the free,
they're free because it probably didn't cost them to make, or like it doesn't go as far. But the thing is like, not even to be like, oh, go download the app, go do this, but it's like, take advantage of this time. Like, it's $1 for your
first month.
By the
way, you have to do that through the website. It'll be linked down below. It's mm-hmm. www.movefit.com. You cannot get that deal on the app store. However, you can sign up on the app store if that's the way you want to do it. It's just going to be more expensive.
But like, don't take this as like, oh, like just go like get the app. Like, that's what they're trying to say. It's like, really, like, no, guys, think about it. $1. You guys have an entire month to decide if you're about this or not.
Well, I'm sick of people like, making excuses. I always see it. I did it in my caption today for the Move app's Instagram account. It's like, no more excuses in 2023.
No.
It's like, what do you need to help you in your fitness? You need short workouts. We got 15-minute workouts. You need someone to hold you accountable. Like, your friends and family and whoever likes you can follow you on the app. You need at-home workouts, we got you. At the gym workouts, we got you.
Don't have equipment,
beginner workouts, we got you. Intermediate workouts, we got you. Advanced workouts, we got you.
Like, I feel like the programs like,
we're here for you. We got you.
They're so
$1 fitness
so
app.
Good.
We got you.
Yeah.
All right.
No, you're good.
I get passionate about it. Like, I really like the fitness app is like, it was just, I only did it like for fun.
It's so cool just because it's like, everything we worked on for so long, and I just know the quality, and I've already seen so much like progress in people. And that's why we wanted to do the 90 day challenge too, is for you guys, because I think sometimes people forget to take those pictures of themselves before and after.
Take transformation
and it's like,
pictures. Do it.
Yeah. And you always say you wish you would have done
it. I wish I would have done it.
But
so
I would
bad.
Say if if this is like your year to get fit, it's like, it's so easy to tell yourself, like, oh yeah, like I'm just going to go to the gym every single day. Like that's my New Year's goal.
Have a plan of action.
You have to have a plan of action and you have to be realistic. Like if you never go to the gym, don't tell yourself you're going to go every single day because you might get burnt out really quick.
Well, that's tip number two, you know, have a plan of action. Mm-hmm. And we're just spitballing off the top of our head, but I feel like that comes natural, you know?
Yeah.
Plan of action for anything you do. It doesn't even just have to be fitness or working out, but to use fitness as an example.
Yeah.
You know,
I think having a plan makes it so much better. And that's why I like using the app too, is because it's not like if I go to the gym and I know a lot of exercises, I could create my own workout. That's a pretty good workout. But when I go and I use the app, like an already like curated workout, I push myself 10 times further and I do so much more or so many more exercises just because, like, I don't know if I was doing it myself, I'd be like, yeah, I think I'm good. Like I feel it in my legs. Right. Like, you know, oh, I think I'm good. But like the app just like pushes me further. And it's not even just like necessarily the app. It's like if you have something written out like for you, and that's like basically what the app does. Like,
not only that, but it also gives you an 8-week program. It breaks it up into like how many times you're working out a week. Yeah. Like it just makes it easy. Like even for myself, like I know workouts is like, but I just want to click a button and see what to do and do it. And when I complete it, it tells me I'm done. Mm-hmm. And then all the people that follow me say, good job. And
they're it's like, you crushed it.
It's hype. It's like, they know I hit my workout. I post a little selfie picture. I check off my habits and I'm good to go. I did my due diligence. You know?
Did the dang thing.
But same, that goes with anything though. You know, yeah. Plan of action.
Yeah. Another thing I really think is important, maybe this is like the third thing. It's not really important. You don't have to do this, but I know this personally helps me because I'm just going to say it. It's like getting a new gym outfit or like picking out a cute, like new gym shoes.
She didn't want to say it because
no,
I know why you didn't want to say it.
Why?
Just because like I everything we like to do, we've made into like a company because it's like we're passionate about it. So it's like get a new gym outfit, but like, hey, we got a sale going on right now.
No, I wasn't even going to bring that up.
Well, I was.
But like...
Because I want you guys to take advantage of the sale. We got a sale on JD Fit.
We do too. Have a really, really fire JD Fit sale going on, but that's not even why I brought it up. I really brought it up just because it's like when I have a cute new gym outfit, I feel so much more confident. And when I feel confident, my workouts are 100 times better. When I look in the mirror and I'm like, ew, I feel so gross today. I like don't, it's not motivating to me. It's not like, oh, I'm going to go harder because I look like shit. Like, yeah. It's like, I'm like, ew, I feel like crap. Like, I don't want to be here. Like, that's kind of how I feel. But like, when I have a cute gym outfit, I was like, I look so good. And then I'm like, yeah, let's go. Like, is that like positive mindset? Well, and like, I just think it makes like going to the gym exciting. And like, maybe you can't afford like a new gym outfit like too often, but that's where you use it as you're like, okay, if I stay consistent.
Well, you got to reward yourself.
Yeah.
That's like if you another go to the, tip. Like,
yeah. If you go to the gym like consistently for a month or something like that, like 5 days a week for like a month, then you reward yourself with a new gym outfit or something like that, like little incentives to reward yourself because you should be proud of all the work that you're putting in.
Like this might be a terrible example, but it popped into my head. Like think like when you're trying to teach a dog a new trick, it's like, come here, like sit. And then you give them a treat. Like you're rewarding them with a treat.
You're giving yourself a treat.
And I swear it's the same thing. And I think I've gotten that from like a motivational book or something I've read. It's like, it really is true. Like
oh,
if
yeah.
you want to start waking up early in the morning, like do it every day. And like tell yourself once you do it like 5 days in a row, give yourself like a treat or whatever it may be. Like
something that excites you.
Because that's just implementing in your brain that like if I do this, I get a reward. Like something good comes from it. Like yeah. if I'm doing this.
And you're also doing like the good habit that you're creating as well, which is good.
You get I was waiting treat. For Topper to like run up on the side. He's over there sleeping.
He like popped his head up.
Camera. He's like pops, treat? Did someone say treat?
Yeah. He's like, oh, what you got for me? But no, I think that's really important.
So that's tip number three. Reward yourself.
Reward
for
yourself.
Accomplishments. That's something we've actually been very bad at. Like
yeah.
a couple years ago. We're getting really good at it.
I think we're a lot better.
We're getting
know.
Better and better at it, but like we would make all these accomplishments and never reward ourselves,
or like celebrate, like, or like we were like proud.
Like always on to the next. Like, what are we doing next? Like, that's why it's like when we come on here even talk about Move Fit or JD Fit, it's like I'm stoked because I'm like because
we're passionate about it.
Yeah, and it's like I should be able to comfortably like talk about it and want to get people to sign up for it because like
at the end of the day,
that's what we've done. Like,
here's the thing: is at the end of the day is. No one's like forcing you. Like someone commented on my Instagram. Actually, they were like, oh, you're just promoting your shitty products because all you care about is making money and you probably don't even use your shitty products. I was like,
bitch. Wear it every
day. And I was like, oh, I'm so sorry you feel that way. I actually love my company and I use all my products like daily. Just be like, I'm sorry you feel that way.
But what's crazy?
That's a very negative outlook on life. And she's like, you're right. I'm sorry. Can you follow me? I'm like, oh my God.
Oh yeah. I was one of those. I mean, what's crazy though is like, if you're promoting like Lululemon, they'd probably be like, oh my God, I love that. I'm like,
yeah.
But now that you're promoting like your own company instead,
oh, you just want to make money. It's
something
like,
that we work hard on, spend hours on every single day. It's like, oh, all you care about is money. It's like, okay, no.
What people don't understand too, especially with like JD Fit, is like when I'm like putting hours and hours like creating like different designs and stuff and like creating all these products and I get them, I sample them, then I have to wait months and months for like the bulk order to get
so
here.
When it launches,
and then like when I get it, I'm like obsessed with it because I created it and I'm like so passionate about it. And it's like, it's not like go buy, go buy, go buy, I need money. It's like, oh my God, I love this so much. Like you need to wear it too. Like I want to see everyone wearing it because yep. I'm like, I created it. So it's like, what they don't understand is it's like, I'm not just selling a product to where I'm like, okay, just give me a pair of leggings, like whatever. Oh, I don't like them. Like, let's just sell them anyway. Well, I don't care about that. I wear my products every single day.
Yeah. Like I would understand that if you dropped like fitness products and you hated working out.
Yeah.
But like it was a trend and it was clear that it was going to make you a lot of money. Like yeah. That would make sense then if someone said that, but like we work out literally every day. Like,
exactly.
We love it. But let's move on. Yeah. Tip number three, reward yourself for accomplishments. What do you got a tip number four, KDB?
Okay. So tip number four, it's not just like, because I don't want to just talk about fitness and stuff like that. I would say tip number four is to write down your goals. And don't just write down your goals for the year. Write down your goals for the year. Write down your goals for the month. Write down your goals for the week. And I think it's so good to constantly, like I get excited for new months. Like don't just be like, oh, it's the new year. Like, and then have to wait all the way to 2024. Literally use each month, each week as like a fresh start, a new beginnings. Each day is a fresh start. It's like write your new goals often and update them because that's something that was huge for us. I mean, we wrote our goals for YouTube and do you know how exciting that was when we were crushing our goals, doing everything that we said we were going to do. And then like we see everything being checked off, like, it just motivates us then for the next month to create new goals. And it's like when you see something, it's like a vision board, like you're seeing what you want to believe and create. And so it comes to life when you like manifest it.
Well, it also like imprints it in your brain. It's not, you know, like it's like it would be cool like if we had all the success on YouTube but like never wrote goals down or anything. But then it'd be like, oh, like what's like, are we just getting lucky? But like when we wrote like, oh, we want to hit this, how are we going to do it? Like post a video every day, do this, this, and this. Like,
yeah. So,
you
that's-
know, like there's like, you know, a plan of action goes back to one of our other tips.
Yeah.
But to reach those goals. And that's why like even writing your goals down every day, those little daily goals are going to help you for your weekly goals, which help you for your monthly goals, which help you for your yearly goals. It's just like you're stacking all this stuff up.
And that's when you write your goals. Like
it's so easy.
Let's say our goal was to get, let's say we just started YouTube. It was to get 50,000 subscribers. So it's like goal, get 50,000 subscribers or whatever. And then it's like in, let's say it was in the year, but then it's like our monthly goals are to be like upload 5 times a week. Never skip that. And then you go through and you're like comment for 1 hour a day, in engagement, and you write all the things, all the checklists that you're going to do to help yourself reach that goal. So it's like the mini goals to get you to that goal.
And you
got to
be realistic and like not that person that writes like, oh, I'm writing my 2023 goals, make $1 million.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
That's all it is. Make $1 million.
But if you really believe that you can
make $1 million,
you could make $1 million.
But how are you going
to
do it?
Yeah. You got to have a plan of action. You can't just say make $1 million. And then not even know what you're going
to
do to make
reverse engineer it. You know, like how are you going to do it? What are the steps to doing that?
Do you believe in New Year's resolutions?
I don't understand, I guess, like the term of a New Year resolution. Like it's just New Year, new me. Like
no, a New Year's resolution is basically like your goal for the New Year's. But a lot of people like don't believe in them because
like goal for the New Year's. I don't think I like the word New Year resolution because I feel like it gets such a bad rep. But I do believe in like that you can flip a switch, you can start something new. It does feel like a fresh start, but like also I want to say like, why wait to the New Year's? Like obviously it's the time, so like people get excited about it, but
yeah,
like you have a fresh start every morning when you wake up technically.
100%.
You know, you don't have to live in the past or worry about the future. It's like do what you want to do that day, you know, like start your fresh start. But I even get excited to write like 2023 goals down and I keep saying like, oh, this year is going to be huge. It's going to be a big year. That's just because mentally, that's how I track, like, okay, like, we did this in 2022. That was awesome. We did this in 2021. Yeah. So for me, it's like a segment where it's like, okay, I'm tracking all of this. Like, would we, now I can look back in 2022. I'm like, we did this, 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 and this. Like, yeah. Super cool. Like, yeah. So I like to track it like that in my head. But like, as far as like, I'm not like, oh, I'm not eating sugar in 2023. Like,
yeah.
Unless that was a big goal of mine, but it's not. But I don't ever write like one like resolution. Like, do you have a New Year's resolution?
No. So for me, my thing is, I kind of look at resolutions as like your New Year's goals. So like
goals, like, I got New Year's
basically goals, just goals that you haven't set, because I feel like a lot of people don't normally set goals, and then it's like New Year's comes around and they're like, you know what, I'm gonna stop doing this. And a lot of people fail their New Year's resolutions because they don't create a plan of action. They don't take it seriously. And then as soon as they fail one time, as soon as they miss out on that gym one time, they're done with it.
Well, real quick, I do want to say, it's like, and people, a lot of people in the gym complain about this, like, oh, it's the New Year's resolution. People are coming in. Like, I always got so excited about that. I'm like, look at all these people, like, finally doing it. Like, they're actually taking, like,
and like,
they're dedicated. They're here. The sad part to me is like, when January finishes and it's like, you see like literally 50% fall off. I'm like, why? Like, you just did it for a month. You literally just proved yourself.
For me, it kind of makes me sad when people act like that. They're like, oh, the gym's so crowded. I'm like, shouldn't you be so happy that like people are getting after like what you also love to do?
I thrive in a crowded gym.
Yeah.
Like, the energy is contagious.
Because you're like, look at how many people are getting after.
I like the energy. When I go to a gym, sometimes like no one there, like obviously I get in the zone, but.
Yeah. Sorry. I accidentally just like kicked him under. I was like,
are you trying to like go and say something? No. Like, what's going on? But like, I thrive in the gym that's crowded. Like, that energy, I'm an energy person. I like when people are around, people are getting after it. It motivates me. It inspires me.
For me, for New Year's resolutions, the reason I like, it's not that I don't believe in them. I just don't like when people like kind of like do like the, yeah, I'm going to do this. And they just like don't have a plan of action. They just say some outrageous goal. But I think it is good to make goals. So I do like them, because I've actually set a New Year's resolution. I'd kind of call it more of a goal, but my goal for, I don't know what year it was. I believe it was like 2016, I think it was. And I was like, okay, my goal is to upload every 2 to 3 days. I cannot miss no longer than 3 days without a YouTube video going up. And because I did that, that is single-handedly the reason that my YouTube channel started taking off. I took it so seriously, and I was not missing my New Year's resolution because of that. So because of my New Year's resolution, I became bigger on YouTube. So I'm like, you know what?
She stopped playing games.
It wasn't that I waited for the new year to do that. It's just like, that's when I was like, I realized, I was like, you know what? I need to take it like seriously. And then I was like, oh, well, the New Year's is in like a couple of days. So it's my New Year's resolution. So that's why I'm like, it's not really New Year's resolutions, because I think you should set those goals. When you have these ideas, it's like, you should set those goals right away. Like, let's say it's like January 30th. It's like, okay, you didn't start your New Year's resolution or your goals. Why not start?
Well, that's the next month. That's the thing I don't like, is like, I've heard people in like literally October be like, oh yeah, like 2024, my goal is to get in shape or whatever year is coming up. And I'm like, it's October. There's 3 months till the new year. Like, why don't we just start now? Like,
well, because a lot of people think they're like, oh, the holidays, like I can't eat bad and this and that. I'm like, it's not like the holidays, like, yes, I understand you have a lot of parties. There's lots of drinking. There's lots of candy and like cookies and stuff, but it's like, you don't have to just not have any of that junk food or like eat so bad for the holidays.
Could be your
like
cheat day.
You know, that could be like your day, like where you're like not eating is, and like, I don't even think you had to eat that strict, but like, why not start working out even if you're not eating the best?
All right, guys, I am about to drop some tea and I'm going to expose KDB, and she doesn't know I did this.
Oh no.
But I went on her iPad and I took a picture of her 2023 goals.
No!
And I want to read a couple of them to you because I think they're awesome. And
wait, I literally gonna forgot. Hit
every single one of these.
Thanks.
So, first one is love her husband.
Oh, shut up.
For her husband, buy him nice gifts. Pretend to be excited about his skydiving, head scratchers, 5-minute massage every night, kiss him more, 10 hugs a day minimum, and don't get hangry.
Josh wrote those goals on the plane. So we're on the plane and like coming back from Michigan.
I airdropped to it to her.
He airdropped to me and he's like, here, you should work on these. And I'm like, shut up. I thought that was actually really cute.
Those are fire goals, no?
Yeah.
Did you think I was actually going to expose you?
I mean, you could. Most of my goals were pretty good.
Well, it's not like...
Did you take a picture of my actual goals?
No, that was it. Those are all your actual goals from here on out.
I know some of them off the top of my head. I'd say one goal of mine is to grow deeper in my faith, which that's more like a personal goal. I would say with JD Fit, I have so many goals. Like, I am so excited. There's like a certain amount of launches I want to hit this year, because the last year, because of the move and everything and some other back end things that were going on with JD Fit, we didn't end up getting as many launches as we wanted. So, that 2023 is going to be huge for JD Fit.
Be crazy. 2023 is the Jordan year of 20.
The Jordan 20s. Year.
Or the 2000s. The 2000s is what I meant.
Yeah,
I said
it is the
20s.
Jordan year. That's crazy. And
the Jordan year is the year we met. So I think
it was your best year. So it's
fire
our best
year. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Come on now. I'm excited. I'm getting like goosebumps thinking about it. But okay, here's some random goals I wrote down. So I write like, you know, self goals.
Me personally, I'm not taking that. Me personally.
Katie's little cousin said that so much when we were back in Michigan. I started saying it.
Anytime
me personally, I'm not going to take that.
He's like, me personally, I'm not taking that. Yeah, I'm like,
me personally, not going to take that.
Okay, but sorry. Anyway.
So I do like self goals, travel goals, business goals, money goals, relationship goals. Like I break them down like that.
Oh yeah, what was in your relationship goal?
Don't worry about it. I don't want to expose those ones. Anyways, like, I just want to share a random one.
Love my wife. Tell my wife she's beautiful at least 10 times a day.
I'll do it. But one personal random goal of mine was to dress up more, like have a little bit more swag.
I feel like you do have
swag. A skincare routine. Oh, yeah. I don't have one of those. Like, I wash my face.
You don't need like a full elaborate, like wild one, but I do think you could use
Katie
a couple.
Yells at me every time I get out of the shower because I scrub my face hard. Sometimes
so
I use shampoo, like whatever's in the shower I use. And then when I dry my face off, I like scrub it hard.
And I'm not
like,
even,
oh my gosh.
I'm not even one of those like full blown skin girlies who's like doing like a million steps. Cause personally, I think a lot of like the companies that like.
Me personally, I'm not taking that.
No, I honestly think a lot of like skincare products aren't really that great for you. That's just a personal opinion. I don't have any like knowledge on that, but I know a lot of times like when I'd use all these different skincares, like these products, my acne would get worse. And then the less I use, the better it would get. But I do think it's important. Like one thing we need to do is always wear sunscreen, use like maybe like one or two like certain oils that'll help our skin and stuff like that. I think just like we're at that age to like take care of your skin. It's like you have to do it while you're young because you can't reverse your skin. So why not?
Yeah, like I just like to do things that I'm going to thank myself for when I'm like 40, 50, 60,
One of
70,
mine is,
like
is to take my vitamins. Oh, stretching is a huge one for me because I'm so bad at making sure I'm stretching. I really, really am going to make sure I drink a ton of water.
Oh, another funny one. I don't know why because I feel like this is so random for me. I want to learn how to cook. Like
really?
I don't want to be like insane, like chef master, but like. I want to whip up some mac and cheese or oatmeal or cereal.
Babe, you can't do that yet. Oh my God. You're not that bad.
No, like I want to be like I'm making this tonight.
Chicken parm.
Like, we got some chicken parm on the menu tonight, you know?
It's honestly really easy. Like, I mean, I'm not like some crazy, you know that. Like, I'm not bad at cooking.
Don't get me wrong. I could definitely do it. But like when I say cook, like, I mean like, you know, make it good. Like
my
something
uncle,
like we're eating like, yo, this is fire. This slaps versus like, oh, this is really good.
My uncle's really good at cooking. Like, but it's not like he's like so passionate about cooking all the time. And like,
I feel like that's
cook.
Such a dad thing. Like,
yeah, true.
Like, I'll grill it up, chef it up. Like, I feel
just
like that's such a dad thing.
No,
we're not there yet.
No,
we're not there yet.
Well, Noah likes cook. A lot of I feel like certain guys like cooking. Like, it's not like a dad thing.
I don't know. It's not something I like. That's why I want to get into it. Because like,
I would think it
I
would
know,
be,
I like to learn stuff.
I think it would be nice if you could cook a little bit just for like, well, I mean, right now I feel like it works for me cooking.
Just so
but
you
then, like,
don't have to.
No. But like, let's say like later down the road, we have like a couple kids and like, I'm busy doing other stuff. And if like, I need you to cook dinner, it'd be nice to know that like, you're not going to like just make oatmeal, you know?
Okay, mom's out of town, dad's home alone with
getting pizza.
With the kids. We getting pizza and crumble cookie. Are you kidding me?
Oh my God.
I'm like, yeah, babe, I'm cooking. We're going to have real healthy meal. I went to
just
Trader
chicken
Joe's.
Chicken and rice and organic vegetables.
Yeah, organic veggies.
Nothing but the best for the kids, honey.
Brown rice, of course. And I also
did. Yeah, can I get double bacon on my pizza? Thanks.
extra ranch on the side, and we'll take wings and breadsticks, of course.
Did you guys want dessert?
No, we're getting crumble later.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, Brocky gonna be eating good one day.
We're not naming our kid Brock. Josh is convinced that when we have a kid one day that we're gonna name him Brock.
It's just a joke.
Comes out a girl. My name is Brock.
That's Brockliana.
Oh gosh.
Brockliana.
I'm worried.
All right, we're gonna need to move on to another tip because I feel like we just got so off topic. I don't even know.
Okay, vision boards. Let's talk vision boards.
Ooh,
you love it. Your vision boards.
I love vision boards. I got one hanging in the closet.
Don't you have one on your phone too?
True. I always forget. My phone is literally a vision board. And honestly,
what's crazy is everything. Let me see it.
On my vision board, it's so stupid. Actually, it's kind of funny. It came pretty much true.
It really did.
There's one thing that hasn't come true yet, but that's okay because it was honestly kind of just a random one.
Yeah, that one was kind of random.
I put on here like fly private, but then like when I really started looking, I was like, it's so expensive to fly private. Like, I'm not going to waste my money. So it'd have to be like free. And then it's like, yeah. Or my own private jet, which I definitely don't own.
No, I thought that goal was cool because it's like,
it's unique.
Okay,
it was unique.
If we wanted to fly private, I think we could like one time. Like, you know, it's not like we couldn't afford it. But I'm not wasting money. Like, I can't waste money. Like, that's a waste of money. So it's kind of like, I don't know. Maybe that goal is like.
Like, to charter a private plane costs insane amount of money. Unless, like, there's certain ones where you can do where it's like kind of private. But like, when I think private, I'm thinking like, you know, the Kylie Jenner experience. You feel me? See, like, there's a butler on the plane.
That's my toxic trait is like, because like, I'll see like certain private jets and I'm like, okay, but like, where are the cashmere seats? Like, where's the bed in the private jet? Like, why is there no bed?
That jet costs $80 million.
Because I would watch some of the Kardashians episodes and I'm like, okay, but like, I'm like, okay, now that's a private jet. But they probably have like the top of the top other than probably like Drake.
I don't even know why I put that on my list. It just sounded kind of cool. I don't know.
It looks cool in the
because
pictures.
This is like when I think boxing or fighting, it's like all like the top fighters, like they always like post like with either their bell or like outside their PJ, like about to take off to head to like the fight location. So like that's like why I think it's in my brain to fly private. And especially like,
but I also think I also think some people like influencers,
I think it would be a super big letdown.
I think some influencers do that and they can't afford it, but they do it just to like front. Like that they're doing it too. Maybe. To bring that whole, and I feel like that's not really you to just like, if you can't like totally like just afford, but even if you could afford it, I don't know, maybe.
No, that's the thing. I'm not cheap, but like I'd rather spend it on
an experience.
Well, that is an
fun.
Experience. I
guess,
it is. But I don't even know. I don't even know why I wrote it down. It, like I said, it just, you see like the fighters always do it. And I'm like, oh.
But Josh does love his vision boards. And so do I, because
I did have fighting on my vision board too. And I'll check that off. Not on this one.
That's
but
what's
on
crazy
my other vision
is because, yeah, I honestly didn't think you were going to fight for like a long time. And then that fight came up.
I didn't think it was ever going
to
fight
you have
again,
another
honestly.
Fight. And I'm so grateful that you get to these opportunities to fight. And it's like such a cool experience for me too, because I mean,
we're literally going to England in a week and a half.
Yeah. Like what? And not only that, like you're fighting at like these big arenas that like, it just like almost seems like something out of a movie that like, I don't know. I can't even explain it. Like, it's so cool to be a part of it. Like a fight week, everything. Like
we're
meet
literally
new people,
living,
new experiences. I'm all about new experiences.
We're living like, our own Creed movie.
Yeah.
Like what?
I'm excited to see that new movie actually.
Is it like, oh man, life is weird. I don't know. That's what I'm saying. That's why you need to reflect. Like that's what today's podcast is about. And it's like,
it is crazy. Like,
it's
I don't
cool.
know.
Like, see, like, I'll do it. Like, I'll have the fight. And, like, in fight week and stuff, I'm like, oh, this is, like, so normal, whatever. And then, like, after I really sit and think about it, I'm like, I literally just fought, like, on a televised, like, broadcasting. Like
so
just me. Like, I remember sitting in my basement, like, 17-year-old Josh. Like, instead of hanging out with my friends on a Friday night, like, I'm watching, like, Bellator MMA, like, a UFC, or not UFC, an MMA fight league. Like, because it was free. It was only one on free on ESPN in my basement by myself just to watch fighting.
It's so cool because, like, I even say
and
that.
Like, now I'm fighting, like.
I even say that to you sometimes. I'm like, think of, like, where you were, like, being, like, a pro MMA fighter and, like, fighting, like, locally. Like, obviously, there's still a good amount of people that go, but it's way different when you're fighting in a crowd, like, the boxing crowd.
This is what, like, any amateur
and
fighter
the, and I'm like
of.
This like, is what like young Joshy B was like working so hard at, and like you found almost like a different route. Like I don't know, it's like it just kind of worked and it all just fell into place.
It's so weird, but again, we're getting off topic, but yeah, that's fun. I'm excited. That's going to happen. That's going to kick off our 2023. We're going to head to England. Oh, like,
this is totally random.
January.
But this helps me. I don't know why. It just helps me so much for the new year is a deep clean the house, like deep clean everything. Clean out your closet, clean everything. Start 2023 with a fresh slate. No like random stuff in your house or other things that can distract you or stuff like that. Like, I don't know. I just feel like when I reorganize stuff.
You got a lot of work to do in our garage, sweetheart.
No, it's
a lot of work.
Okay, then I'm going to start throwing away if you want me to start going to work, I'll go to work. I will go to work.
The garage is like kind of all me, so.
It's really not. It's not a mess. It's like we just got to get organization shelves. But everything else in our house is very, very organized. And I feel like it helps me so much more in life. I don't know why. But I feel like this is a good time to do it, especially like, I don't know, maybe you're younger and you still have time off from before you're about to start school soon, like in life gets so busy. This was the only time in my life was on winter break from school that I actually had, and that's actually, wait a minute, what day is today?
Oh,
tomorrow
my gosh.
Is my 10-year anniversary on YouTube.
I was gonna say, I'm a terrible husband.
And,
holy
and
crap.
Josh is like, oh, why'd you start like on a random day like December 31st? I was like, it wasn't random. It was just because it was the only time in my life in high school that I wasn't doing sports or I didn't have school that I had free time to upload a video. So like use that time right now to clean your room, like freshen up, like everything. Like, I don't know, just write your goals, write vision boards. It's honestly, it's so exciting to do vision boards and goals. Like it's exciting. Like I just get so excited to think about what could be, you know?
That like motivates me to like move forward and like do crazy stuff like that. And like you gotta, that this is one of mine and it's kind of random, but like dream big. Like I hate when people, like if someone tells you like, oh, like that's crazy, like that's almost a compliment to me, you know? Like to be like, oh, I'm gonna do this and this, like, and they're like, yo, that's crazy, like, yeah, bet. Because I'm dreaming big, and like if I fall a little short of that, it's still super dope.
It's
like
still sick,
you know what I'm saying? Like I want to own my own PJ one day, just to, on the topics of private jets. Like, why wouldn't I? Who wouldn't? Like, that's cool. Like, I want to do crazy things.
It is. But what's so crazy is like, we've had crazy goals and a lot of them have come true. So it's like, if we weren't dreaming big, then I don't think a lot of these things would be happening. So it's like, dream big, but dream realistic, but also big at the same time, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
You know, like make small goals and like work towards them. And then once that goes, like keep dreaming big. Don't sell yourself short and don't be like, this is the only job I'm ever going to work at. Like I've just accepted it. Why? Why can't you go look at other jobs, get a fire resume and like learn all the skills you can in your job. And then when you're maxed out, grow from that and go to a next job or like keep going more and more. Cause it's like, it's not even about the money. It's not like, oh, you can make more money from this company or this or that. It's like you can grow as a person and get a better job and like better, you can create better things for yourself. Cause I feel like sometimes we've had like different either employees or I've seen different people and I'm like, if they just excelled a little harder in their job and they applied to other places, they could probably be in a better position than they're in right now. It's like, but sometimes people are so stuck in the mindset. Like they're like, well, they're comfortable. It's like, get out of your comfort zone and keep pushing for better for yourself.
That's the biggest thing.
Like one person I feel like who's really good at that is our friend Bree Shook. I feel like she's always like, okay, what's the next thing? Like if this job isn't giving me what I want, like I'm going to go look for something else. Or I'm going to, you know, like people who are like always looking for like the next thing, but they're not so scared to just stay where they're at.
Yeah. I mean, you got to get out of your comfort zone for like anything that is going to propel you in life, you know, like trying something new is uncomfortable. I don't know, moving to a different state's uncomfortable. Trying
out,
a new school's uncomfortable.
Working out's uncomfortable.
Going to the gym for the first time's uncomfortable. Working out at your house for the first time's uncomfortable.
If you guys are headed to the gym for the New Year's resolution, just remember, no one's staring at you. I know sometimes it might feel like that, especially if you're new to the gym. Cause I felt that way. I was so scared to go to certain machines. I felt so intimidated because I didn't know what I was doing. But like now after being in the gym for so long, I was like, actually, sometimes I was so worried about what I was doing that I realized I didn't even know who was around me or I didn't even look at anyone else, you know? Like I didn't ever like be like, oh, why is that person wearing that? That's so unflattering to her. Oh, why is she's using that gym machine wrong? Like that's not reality. Like I really don't think people, unless you're like hanging upside down on the bars or something,
crazy monkey stuff.
Yeah.
You know what's like, crazy is when I first started working out, like that was back in the days where you didn't wear like a gym fit.
You were, you know, like, crappy.
Like, you wore gym. Like, you're like,
that makes you sound old.
Doesn't it?
Because I never went to the gym when it was like that, but my mom did. My mom used to go to the gym like, in her cleaning clothes, like her, like almost like crap that I would wear where it looked like Adam Sandler.
Yeah, see, I'm not saying mine is not that bad, but it's like you're wearing like your crusty, like, oh, like high school soccer shirt or middle school, like.
It wasn't JD Fit.
Yeah, like it wasn't like JD Fit, Gymshark, whatever the people are wearing these days. But like now when I go to the gym, it's like, yeah, I got my fit on. Like,
yeah.
You know, like this is my gym fit. Like I get stoked to put it on. Like versus like it was like, oh, let me throw my workout clothes on. And well, just, like, random.
I do have to say, I'm so glad that athleisure like made such a big come.
That's what I'm saying. Like
in the past like 10 years, like because it's just so comfy and it's cute and I feel like it's flattering and it never can go out of style. So.
And it helps you better never. It makes you work out way harder when you got it, when you're feeling yourself, you know?
If I went to the gym in like baggy sweatpants, like I don't know.
Yeah.
I feel like I wouldn't be feeling the same, you know?
Like I was wearing Champion to the gym before Champion was cool. Like it was like the Target brand.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was
yeah.
Like $5. Like, oh my God. Crusty hoodie. Like I don't know. This podcast is so random. Like
I knew it was going to be random, but I feel like it's always,
I like it.
I don't know. It's good. And when you're talking about goals, it's fun, everything random. To come for 2023, what do you think is going to come for us in 2023? I think that for JD Fit, I think JD Fit's going to really pop off. I really think Move's going to pop off. And I think it's going to be cool because both of our companies go side by side. Like, I just feel like they're two big passion projects of ours. Like, mm-hmm. We love working out. And we love working out so much that we love the clothing that we wear when we work out. And we love athleisure so much, even outside of the gym. And they just go so hand in hand. It's like, okay, you work out, you need a gym fit. Like, I don't know. I just see both of those companies. Like, I feel like Move is going to like reach so many people. Yep. And I feel like it's going to do some crazy things. I think we're going to do a lot of things I can't even announce with Move, like different things that we might be a part of and like really, really big projects with that. That I'm really excited about.
Yeah, for me, it's like I want to start creating that. Like that's what we love. Like I want to start like slowly creating that community like bigger. Yes. Because like that's what like. Like people always like, I feel like say someone that owns a business or whatever, like, oh, all they care about is money. Like, honestly, for me, what I like and KDB can attest to this is like that community. Like when yeah. I was used to work at my old job, it was title boxing. Like I was just a trainer there. A couple of my buddies worked there. We all trainers there. And like 40 people would come in, take a class every like couple hours. And it's like the community was
the vibes
so,
were so
dope.
High.
The
it was
vibes
so fun.
Were so high. Like, we would go out, like we would have a Christmas party with all the members, like everybody knew everybody. And like, I just really liked the community. You like just, everybody, they would come to my fights.
I
like,
truly don't
they knew
believe
stuff about my friends. Like we were all like,
I don't
like,
believe
it was like a big family. And like, that's what's so cool about the JD fam. This yeah. podcast is like, that's what we were always trying to create with the JD fam. And I think we have. And now like, I want to also create like that with our
I want
to
bring
working out like that's what we love to do. Like I want to start creating that community. Like,
I think
that's
with
what
JD
me.
Vlogs, it's like we created like a sense of like entertainment for people. And I love that because I've always loved to entertain people since I was like little.
Yeah.
But then it's like also as I get older, it's like I want to bring not only entertainment, but I want to bring value to people's lives. Like that's, I want to things that I've learned in my life that I'm so grateful.
But
that
entertainment does add value. As
entertainment
well,
is value
because it's an escape.
But I mean
or
other values.
Is.
Other values that I'm also passionate about. So it's like all my passions that I, if any way I can bring value to someone, then that would just like fulfill me. And it is crazy. Cause like, I know like a lot of times it's like people don't understand how businesses work, blah, blah, blah. And we talk about this a lot,
yep.
But it's like, we make enough money on YouTube to live our lives. We really don't have like some crazy lifestyle to where we're like buying all these like random things. Like we live a very, like, I feel like humble spending life like yeah. normal within like, but what I'm trying to say is like, I'm never sitting here like, oh, I'm going to like promote JD so I can buy this like Louis Vuitton bag or I can do, I'm like, I don't even think about things like as money. Like to me, I'm like, I want everyone in the gym to be rocking JD Fit. I'm like, how cool would that be? Like, I want to grow the biggest company. Like, I just know how it makes me feel. And I'm like, I want others to feel that way. And that's what I'm passionate about. Like I get so excited about like designing everything and like all the workouts. And like when I complete like a Move app and when I see all these people who, all these messages of people who are like, oh my gosh, like my life is like already changing, like using the Move app. Like I literally feel so much more confident.
That's
I feel like this. I'm like,
me,
I'm like,
right
let's
there.
Go. Like, let's yeah. freaking go. Like it just, I don't know. It fuels me and I love it.
Like what initially started like the Move app, like ideas when during COVID, when COVID hit and we started a separate fitness channel on YouTube.
Yeah.
And we were just posting like 5 minute abs, like 10 minute booty workout, like, and seeing like how many people A got results from it and B were like, oh my gosh, this helped me so much. Like that was like, oh my, like that feeling is addicting. Like to see people like what you're putting out there and grow from it. Like they get the value and what you're putting out. Like to me, that's what does it for me.
Yeah.
I love that.
And I really do believe it created such a community even during like COVID and everything like that. So I thought that was really fun.
Yes. With that being said, we are wrapping up 2022. Tomorrow is the eve.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow's New Year's Eve.
Oh, tomorrow's New Year's Eve?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, we better make some plans.
I know.
It's already tomorrow.
We do have plans. I thought I told you about that, but if not,
we have plans, guys. We have plans.
We do have plans, guys. But yeah, I mean, I hope you guys had an awesome 2022. Thanks for supporting us. This was like something that started towards the end of the year, and we're excited to keep going throughout 2023. We want to bring guests on the show eventually.
That is something we definitely want to do for 2023. I think it'd be a lot of fun to just like bring different people on and just like, I feel like our possibilities are endless with this podcast.
For us, it's just
so fun. And like, I don't know. It's just like
right now, we're just doing it for fun. And I hopefully it's entertaining for you. Maybe you learn a little or maybe not. Or maybe you sit there and like make fun of us the whole time. But
hey.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe, leave a review on Spotify or Apple Podcasts if you're listening there.
2023 is going to be your guys' year.
And share this with somebody that is going to help motivate or, mm-hmm. you know, just need some entertainment in their life. You know, help the Couple Tea podcast grow out there. And,
you know,
we got some fire, spicy, sizzling tea coming up for you guys in 2023. But this is a wrap for 2022. This is it.
All right,
17 episodes in. We will see you guys in the next episode in the new year, baby.
Bye, guys.
Peace.